during their interface with the Parliamentary Committee of Finance over the Development Plan Implementation Programme, officials of the Civil Society Budget Advocacy Group, CSBAG, decried insufficient budget allocations by the government to address skyrocketing domestic arrears. According to the Auditor General's report of the financial year that ended June 2022, domestic arrears have increased from 4.65 trillion shillings to 7.55 trillion shillings in a space of 1 year.
Aware that the ministry came up with a strategy to clear and prevent domestic arrears, we have a strategy in place. However, domestic arrears has continued to increase annually over the years. If you look at the chart that we have provided, you can see as of 2017-18, the arrears stood at 2.7 trillion. But to date, now our arrears are shot up to 7.5 trillion, which is a huge chunk of money that government is holding. And yet this is the money that we need to pay the suppliers who have supplied government with these goods and services.
However, the 200 billion shillings which was budgeted to clear arrears in the financial year 2023-2024 is a big concern to civil society organizations, which believe it's a drop in the ocean given the burden of stock of domestic arrears. They are concerned that the failure by government to clear its suppliers is crowding out the private sector.
Even in the ministerial policy statements for financial 23-24, government only commits to pay a total of 200 billion towards clearing domestic arrears. So we feel that this amount of money is insufficient for us to clear the burden that we have at hand. And if this is not done, it's going to really impact negatively and stifle growth, especially from the private sector.
Civil society organizations now want the accounting officers responsible for accumulating these arrears to be sanctioned for committing government into excess arrears, as the Public Finance Management Act stipulates.
All these accounting officers who have subsequently accumulated arrears should be subject to sanctions allowable by Section 79 and 80 of the Public Finance Management Act. This is already clear in the strategy, where the PSST has the powers to sanction and make sure that these accounting officers who have always committed government to arrears where we don't have monies to pay, they bear the burden.
However, the Finance Committee members blame it on the Minister of Finance, which is not appropriating adequate funds for MDAs to settle the accruing arrears.
If Minister of Finance would stick to the Appropriation Act as per what Parliament has allocated, I think the accounting officers would have less problems. Again, the PPDA Act, I think with the procurement, we have what they call framework procurement, where even if you don't have money, but you have an agreed understanding with the supplier, they will continue to supply. And that is premised on the fact that you know that your budget has been approved and allocation has been made to you, you're expecting releases. But the challenge has been, what is approved? Is that what is released?
1 trillion we've accumulated, it contradicts the figure which Ministry of Finance said they have of 2 trillion. Maybe you can clarify, does it include the amount paid out in the previous financial years?
The Civil Society Budget Advocacy Group also recommended the government to adequately resource the Budget Monitoring and Accountability Unit to enable it effectively monitor projects and provide real-time implementation to establish value for money for informing decision-making. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.